everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas. Good evening and welcome to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada for our main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. Great atmosphere here tonight. You talk to everybody ringside and they expect this one to be a barn burner. Muhammad Ali's on his way to the ring right now, and you can see how excited he is for this one. Lots of confidence. He's showing you that intensity that so many of the very best will display during a ring walk. Totally focused.
Introducing first, in the blue corner, fighting out of Louisville, the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali! His adversary, hailing out of Brooktown, the blockbuster, Marciano!
All right, fellas, let's have a good, clean fight. Touch them up and let's go.
Opening 3 minutes of this 10-round fight. That's a forceful two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. In a matchup like this, Teddy, we know the outside fighter is going to try to stay away from that power puncher. But what about the outside fighter putting forth his own offense? What can we look for and expect from him?
Well, distance will create offense for him. Misses will create offense. What he has to do is allow the aggressive fighter, the power guy, to do some of his work for him. When he tries to get in, make a miss, make him pay.
It's okay. Pay him back.
Solid straight right hand. Crashes home with a hook. Cut is becoming a distraction to him. You can see that. He's really concerned about it. How can he protect it against his opponent?
Well, right now, I think there's always three lines of defense. You know, you block, you move your head, or you use your legs. Right now, use your legs. Get a little distance, get on that horse a little bit, and give the medicines that were put in that cut a chance to work.
And now just wasting everybody's time holding on.
Hook off the jab. Combo.
Oh, what an uppercut.
Looking good. All right.
Just knifing up with that uppercut by Muhammad Ali. Last 10 seconds of this first round. Well, we've been waiting all week to call this one. Teddy, what kind of fight are you expecting?
Well, the kind of guys that they get insulted if you miss them, Joe.
You need to move your head, okay? Side to side. Lean to the side. Ooh, count. You have to double jab, all right? Just time it. Every time you come in.
Here we go. Round two is underway. There's the hook. Look at this. Another power punch able to land. We're early on in this fight. He's going for it.
Yeah, you wonder if he's got a call waiting outside.
Muhammad Ali with the hook. Teddy, he did a smart thing right there. Just created enough space and then landed the counterpunch.
Looked like the will of the wisp, the old great Willie Peck. Made him miss, made him pay.
Heading into this fight, we talked about what each man can do offensively. What each man wants to do is have varied punches throughout.
Exactly, and what he doesn't want to do. He doesn't want to be predictable.
Well-placed hook to the head. Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. See, that's the work they want to see with the right hand by Muhammad Ali. And now he scores with that left to the body. Commits to the overhand right, and it serves him well. Teddy, is it raw skill? Is it technique? What's the answer for him? Why is he missing so many punches and tiring himself out here?
It's forgetting about the idea. The idea that it's not enough just to throw a punch. You have to have a plan to land it. You know, you have to have a missile to get it to the target. Otherwise, what does it do? Just blows up, makes a hole in the ground, and when it rains, guess what? You go swimming. He's going to go swimming later.
Come on!
And that's the end of round two. Well, we've seen this before, a fighter with a bad cut, and sometimes a fighter that now has a much greater sense of urgency.
Yeah, right now, if he was gambling, if he was in a casino, he's rolling the dice, he's hoping to come up with seven.
Don't stand toe-to-toe with this guy. You gotta keep your distance, all right? That was good. Nice work. Beautiful. That head movement. I want to see double jabs.
And round number three is underway. Now hugging on the inside. Nice block. Ali's nailed by a shot upstairs. Off to the side. A little swing and a miss going upstairs. Defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault.
Head and body, head and body.
What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Muhammad Ali.
Come on, kid. Bolster.
Ali's really in position to control things in this fight if he can do what he did just there, and that's land a good, solid jab. Good-looking uppercut that time. Teddy, throughout his career, Ali has always been surrounded by many very familiar faces in his entourage.
Yeah, it makes him feel comfortable. And, you know, I'm not to be derogatory about it, but to be quite frank, he has the kind of personality where, you know, he wants to be the boss. You know, he wants to be the guy that stands out in the room. So he has guys around him that allow him to stand out in that room. And that's most of the characters that you're going to see, most of the people you're going to see in that entourage.
A good block. And the bell rings, signifying the end of the round.
Good job in that round.
Listen, I need to see some talent, okay? Whatever he misses, talent.
Mm-hmm. Ali's out in front as we take a look at Teddy's scorecard for the first time tonight, but they're still in a mode of just feeling each other out. Neither man has taken control of this bout so far.
Punch him, move! Oh, hands up! Hands
fires
up.
Off the hook. Look at that. Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpuncher. You got a guy coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
Ali's able to land a good, solid left hand. And now he's targeting upstairs. Halfway through round number four. Well, he missed that right. He gets to him with an uppercut. Oh, man, he's in rough shape after absorbing that blow. Smart punch right there. The uppercut works. Right hand over the top. Very accurate with it.
Keep moving. Keep moving.
10 seconds to go in the fourth. Puts forth the hook, scores with it. Good block by Ali. I don't know, Teddy. It just feels like one of those nights, one of those fights where somebody's getting hurt, where this is not going to the judges' scorecards.
I feel like I'm in Coney Island watching one of those hot dog eating contests where somebody's going to try to eat 50 of them, 60 of them. In other words, he's not worried how he's going to feel at the end of the night.
Listen, I don't want to see you against the rope. As soon as you feel rope, move out. There you go.
Back to live action now in what has been a closely contested fight. One of those fights that somebody is still waiting to break through and be a difference maker in. Ali's damaged by that shot upstairs. Muhammad Ali with a huge right hand. Ali's jab lands well. Good defensive skill. Did you see that? Targeting that head and landing with a bomb. But he's going to continue on, beating the count. Good block there by Muhammad Ali. Needs to improve that accuracy, missed with the headshot. Halfway into round number five here.
Finish with the hook.
Keep moving. Keep moving. You got this one.
And now he scores. And all of a sudden, the tables turn. Muhammad Ali's rocks.
What's good for you is good for him.
Muhammad Ali blocks that punch. Muhammad Ali, his legs back underneath him now. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head.
One, two, one, two. Move your head.
Coming to the end of round number five, last 10 seconds. Keeping his hands up, getting way of his opponent's effort. Now he's trying to create an opportunity here as he backs him up against the ropes. A very fan-friendly round, but a headache for the judges. How do you possibly score that round when each man was able to hurt the other?
Well, this is where you have to be a good judge. You have to be a professional judge. You have to use the information that's there. Who won the spots of the round before they each hurt each other? And who hurt the other guy a little more?
Six. Hurt. Keep on. Jab, jab, and throw. Throw to the body, then to the head, then finish to the body.
Start of this round, start to the second half of this fight. First half of this fight, he completely dominated the action, Chad.
Yeah, but you know what? It's kind of like they said in that movie, The Gambler. You know, they don't pay off at halftime. Remember the guy wanted to collect
Absolutely.
His bets? Well, same thing. He's got another half of the fight. Can he be consistent? Can he keep his concentration? Can he keep doing what he's been doing?
And now you can see him utilizing the jab.
You know, a lot of times you see a guy on the outside bouncing around, staying away. You understand the use of a jab. But when you're coming forward, you have to come forward with a cover. And that jab, that's the cover.
He said he was going to do it from the outside, and now he has. He just got to his... Oh, and there you go. Wow, is this good stuff. What good stuff. He just scored the knockdown after being knocked down earlier.
Joe, that's incredible. And the knockdown earlier actually set up this knockdown because his opponent, he got a little reckless, a little careless.
Three, four, five. Muhammad Ali's back up. But is he back in the fight?
We're going to find out in a second whether or not he moves his head. Now, if he just stands there straight and you're the trainer, you better get up on those steps and stop it. He's not right.
Halfway through round six. Nice solid left hand scored by Muhammad Ali. Ali is showing that he has an understanding of a balance, about angles. Look at that. He was able to get up and continue on last time. Now he goes down again.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
It's over. The fight is over. Muhammad Ali's unable to continue. This fight is over. Knockout. It's exactly what he was trying to do tonight. All that hard work and training leading up to this fight, and he gets the result he wanted, a knockout.